Hey everyone, welcome back. Today we are talking about something we all should be doing, but probably don't think about enough: backing up your PC. I have actually lost several files before, and let's be honest, it's the worst feeling. Whether it is important work documents, videos, personal photos, or even your entire system, losing data can be a headache. But here's the good news. There is a super simple way to back up everything on your PC so that if anything ever goes wrong, you are covered. I'm going to walk you through how to back up your entire system, disk, and individual files using AOMEI Backupper. Step by step, no complicated settings, just a straightforward guide to keeping your data safe. Now let's get straight into it. First of all, you need to download and install this software. I will leave a link to AOMEI Backupper in the description. Click the link and you will be landed on this page. Now on their official website, you can learn everything about their products and services. Now here you have to select AOMEI Backupper, which will be the first software, will be shown at the first page of the website. So just click on download freeware and the software will be downloaded. Once it's finished downloading, open the file and install the application. Select your language and then you will be landed on this page. Now here it will ask you to try AOMEI Backupper Pro for free. So here you can either skip it or you can just try the pro version for free. And on the pro edition, everything will be better. Like you will get better technical support. The backup and restore speed will be faster. You will have advanced backup and restore features, cloning, and much more. Here I recommend you to just try the pro version for free. So click on try the pro version for free and then click on install now. Once the installation finishes, click on enjoy now. And then professional trial version of AOMEI Backupper will be opened. Now this is the dashboard of this software, and in this video we're going to be exploring how to backup your system, files and disks. But besides that, you can also explore syncing, restore, cloning, all these features. Now before starting the backup process, make sure to create your AOMEI account. So for that, just click on login at the top and then under login page, click on sign up. Now just create your AOMEI account, entering your email address, entering the verification code and creating a strong password. Once your AOMEI account is created, come back to AOMEI Backupper and click on login. Now use your email address and password and then again click on login and you will be logged into your AOMEI account. This is important, and in this AOMEI account, every backup you do will be saved. So make sure to save your login credentials securely. Now this is the standard version. But if you want to upgrade, you can just click on upgrade, and the professional version actually will have more advantages than the standard version. But as we get the trial version for 30 days, we can use it for 30 days. And if we are really impressed with this software, then we can go for upgrading to paid plans. And if you want to see their plans, here you can click on upgrade now. And they have three pro plans. First one is yearly, which is $34.95. And the second plan is lifetime plan, and that will cost nearly $60. Where you will get a lifetime license for AOMEI Backupper. Also, there is a family lifetime plan, which is really one of the best plan in my opinion, and it has a great discount of 74%. And here you will get 5 license code, which you can use for 5 PCs, and it is just costing $89.95. So if your friends or family member want to use AOMEI Backupper and backup their system, disks and files, then you should consider choosing the family lifetime plan, which is just $89, and per person it's gonna be costing around $17. So for $17 you will get a lifetime license of AOMEI Backupper. Now to make the backup and restore more faster and getting access to cloning functionalities, I am going to be buying the professional 1-year plan. So here let me quickly purchase this plan and then we'll start the backup tutorial. Now I have successfully bought the yearly plan, and you actually don't have to do that. Just use the free trial plan, and whenever you are ready to upgrade, then you can go for the professional plan. So we are now here in the homepage of AOMEI Backupper. It's a really simple software for beginners. It is not that confusing at all. Now here let's select the backup option. Now at first here we get the system backup option. Here you can backup your Windows and create an image system partition. And here you will get your local C drive where your system has been stored. And then under here you can select the disk to backup. Now next we have disk backup option where we can backup hard disks to an image file. So here you can just click on add disks, and here you will get all the disks that your PC currently have. Just select all these disks and you can click on add and you can backup your disks. Now next, we have partition backup option, where we can backup different partitions or dynamic volumes to an image file. Here's the same thing, we have to add the partition or volume here, and then we can select the destination disk, and then we can start backing up the partition. And this is what I'm gonna be showing you how you can do that. Now next, you can easily backup files and folders to an image file as well. So all you have to do is just click on add folder or files which contain your personal data or any work related data and click open, and then you can select a local path, or also you can select the cloud drive. Here AOMEI actually gives 1 terabyte of data, so you can select that, but here I'm gonna be selecting a partition drive. So here I'm gonna be selecting the volume E, and let's click on open, and then we can just click start backup, and it will start creating the backup of our selected folder or files. Now this is not what I'm gonna be showing in this video, so I'm gonna be canceling this. So let's click on cancel, and here you can see the backup process was canceled, but this file backup has been automatically generated, and I can delete this if I want. Now let's move on to the most important part, which is backing up our system disk drive. Now also here you can backup your email data or Outlook data, but that's not that important. If you want, you can do that. Now we're gonna be doing partition backup, so let's select partition backup, and here we're gonna be adding the partition. So let's click on add partition or volume, and here I have 3 volume. The first is the system drive. The C drive is actually the system drive where my OS and all the data has been stored, and next were actually empty partition volume that I have just recently created. Now if I want to backup all these data to any external hard drive or pen drive, then I can just do that here as well with the help of AOMEI Backupper. I can just plug in the external hard disk or flash drive, and it will be shown here, and I can backup my Windows system data to there as well. Now here let's select C drive. Now here it says if you want to backup the system partition to ensure bootable after restore, would you like to use the system backup function to realize the operation? Here I'm going to be select no. I can do the system backup later, which is going to be the same process. So here let's select no. Now as you can see, the C drive has been added. Now under here we have to select the disk drive where we want to backup our data. Now here I already have E drive, but I want to select the D drive. So here I'm going to click on select a local path, and then we're going to go over to this PC, and here we'll get all the device and drives. So if you plug any external drive, you will get that option here as well. And then you can backup your C drive data to that external disk drive or flash drive. But here I'm going to be choosing this D drive. So let's select D, and let's click on open. Now once you accurately selected your drive where you want to backup your partition data, now to start the process, now to start the backup, just click on start backup at the bottom right. And then backing up the data of your local drive C will be started. And as you can see, it is really fast because I am upgraded to the pro plan. But if you are using the free trial plan, it will be a little slower than this. But you don't need to worry about that. Whenever you are ready, you can go for the pro plan. I think it's going to be taking like 2 minutes. So let me skip this process until it gets finished. As you can see, the operation has been completed. Once the backing up of your data is completed, now you can just click on finish, and here you can see it under my backup. And this is the backup we just recently created for our local C drive. And under devices and drives, as you can see, the D drive has been filled and the data has been backupped to this drive. Now if we open this folder, you will find a folder named my backup, and under my backup there will be another folder, and here you can see its size is actually 36 GB. And here AOMEI Backupper actually applied the compression to backup files, and the backup folder, as you can see, is actually really smaller than the original huge space on C drive. Even though my C drive had 70 GB of data, the backup only took like 36 GB because of the redundant data was compressed. Now you can also open this folder. Once you open it, you will see your C drive here, and here you'll find each and every backupped files and folder. Now here under backup management, I have this 3 horizontal line right to my backup, and if I click on it, as you can see, here I get all these options: backup, restore, schedule, editing the backup, deleting, shortcuts, advance, and properties. And here if I select advance, I can explore, check, merge, and look at images here. Now here are the important features I want you to know. It's scheduling feature. So you can actually schedule your backup by enabling it. So if you enable it, you can schedule your feature daily, weekly, or monthly basis. And then you can choose the date, time, and everything. And you can check this box if you want to wake the computer to run the scheduled tasks, and if you want to shut down after it completed. Now on the free plan, you might not see some of these options. but you can run it weekly, monthly, and daily. Now we are not going to do that for now, so let's click on cancel. Now here, if we select on our backup, here we get a play button, and this is actually a shortcut to start a new backup based on your existing backup tags. So this can actually will allow you to run another backup using the same settings, so you don't need to create a new backup. So if we just click on this button, now here you can read, do you wish to create an incremental backup based on the last backup created? So here you can actually update your backup without creating a new one, and you can run an incremental or differential backup. So if you want to run it, you can just do it here. And if you want to leave a comment, which is optional, you can just leave a comment. I'm just gonna write backup, and then let's click on OK. And then the backup operation will be started. But right now we don't need another backup, so I'm just gonna cancel it, and let's click on OK. And then let's click on yes. And the operation has been cancelled. Let's click on finish. Alright, that's it for this tutorial. Now you know how to safeguard your system files and entire disk using AOMEI Backupper. You know, backing up, it's not something like we think about every day, but it is really important. When something goes wrong, it can be helpful for us. And if you have not backupped your system yet, click the link in the description and pinned comments and download AOMEI Backupper for free now and get your backup done faster. Now, if you found this helpful, drop a like and leave a comment. And let me know if you have any questions. I will be happy to help. And if you want to clone your SSD and know everything about cloning, then make sure to subscribe to this channel, because I will be posting that video soon. And thanks for watching. I will catch you in the next one.